Hello friends, it's me JJ, and it is time for one of this channel's most beloved reoccurring bits, flag mysteries. So our first mysterious flag comes from my friend Lincoln, who is a student in California. He says they have this flag hanging up in his school's computer lab, and he doesn't know what it is. So this one wasn't too hard for me to recognize because it has been in the news a fair bit recently. This is the old flag of Syria that was in use from the time of the country's independence from France in 1946 up until 1963, at which point a gang known as the Ba'ath Socialist Party took power in a military coup and changed the flag to this. Under various dictators, the Ba'ath Party has been ruling Syria ever since, up until today, when it is under the rule of Ba'ath Party leader Bashar al-Assad. Now, it would not be an exaggeration to say that the Ba'ath Party's 57-year dictatorship has not been great for a lot of Syrians, particularly over the last few years, where the country has descended into severe chaos and civil war. And whenever these sorts of things happen, there is often a lot of nostalgia for old flags, which are seen as symbols of the good old days before everything went wrong. Accordingly, the pre-1963 Syrian flag has become a popular symbol among anti-government resistance fighters in Syria and their supporters around the world, including, apparently, Lincoln's computer teacher. Flag mystery solved. So my friend Dakota says, I picked up a few of these strange fabric flag identifiers in an antique store in Spruce Grove, Alberta, and I was rather confused about two of the flags in particular. Obviously, they are all labeled, but the Finland and Poland flags threw me for a loop, as I had never seen these flags to represent these countries before. Based on the set they came with, which was a lot of pre-World War I flags, I kind of assumed they are maybe flags representing the region during the Russian Empire, but I haven't been able to find them anywhere online or what this set of flags was a part of. If you could do some better sleuthing, that would be pretty neat. All right, so my initial sleuthing determined that these things are souvenirs known as silks, that used to come in cigarette packages back in the day. They were these little cloth patches with cool pictures on them that you could like sew on your bag or use to make a quilt or whatever. Giving away collectibles in cigarette packages was one of the charming ways that our friendly friends at Big Tobacco tried to lure women and children into smoking. By searching through some antique sites, I was able to come up with some higher resolution versions of the Poland and Finland silks, which you can see here. I was also able to determine that these things were released by the cigarette brand BDV in 1912, which means that Dakota was right when he assumed that they predated World War I. Now, as Dakota alludes to, Finland and Poland were not independent countries at that time, but rather dominions of the Russian Empire. The Polish dominion was a thing that we now often call by the awkward title of Congress Poland, because it was created by the Congress of Vienna that ended the Napoleonic Wars in 1815. It was officially declared to be a sovereign kingdom, but in practice, it was just a province of Russia with the Russian emperor as their king. And for a brief period, this was apparently their flag, with a Polish eagle in the corner and a big blue St. Andrew's cross, which was a symbol of the Russian emperors in those days. Now, in 1864, the Russians took away whatever small shreds of independence Poland had, and that included national symbols. And I assume this is why the Congress flag is mostly forgotten today. Finland, meanwhile, had a similar phony baloney setup, where they were technically sovereign, but their Grand Duke just always happened to be the Emperor of Russia. He was a busy guy in those days. As far as I can tell, the flag of Finland during this time was this, although this flag was associated with Finland's previous rule by Sweden, and not all that popular as a result. So where did this thing come from then? Well, this is a good example of why it is always good to be wary of flag guides created before our modern communications technology. Since you couldn't just Google things in 1912, a lot of people's knowledge of foreign flags was informed by much simpler methods, such as what they saw once. And my theory is that some guy must have just seen this flag flying somewhere in Finland, possibly on a Finnish ship, and then made a mangled drawing of it, which looked like this. And then this would be what the smoking children of America would then wrongly learn was the flag of Finland. In reality, according to the website Flags of the World, this was really just some sort of Russian flag used by their customs department. You can see that in the correct version, it has the Russian flag in the top left. Let's talk about what's going on in the bottom corner though, because that's kind of interesting. You can see we've got two of these things where the snakes are coiled around the rod with the wings at the top. This is what they call the caduceus. And of course today, we mostly think of it as a symbol of medicine, but in the old days, it was often used as a symbol of trade and commerce as well. There is apparently quite the lively debate in the symbology world over which meaning is the more correct one. In any case, flag mysteries solved. All right, so the next flag mystery comes from my friend Iago, who sends me these photos and says, these images are from January 8, 2005, taken at Bosmansgat, or Bushman's Hole, while David Shaw and Don Shirley were preparing to dive to recover Dion Dreyer's body in a recovery attempt. I recognize the South African flag at the top and the Australian, Chinese, UK, and Hong Kong flag, but the one on the far right is a mystery to me. It must be related to South Africa, but that's all I can tell. All right, so Bushman's Hole is one of these freakish places that is very beloved by a certain narrow subculture of thrill seekers. It's this giant 900 foot deep sinkhole located right in the middle of the South African desert. Because this is some of the deepest water you can access without being on the open ocean, the spot is a real mecca for members of the so-called deep water diving community. And this photo Iago is showing us is from this very famous episode in the history of Bushman's Hole, where this one diver drowned in it, and then this other diver made it his mission to find the body, which he somehow did, though he did not live to tell the tale. So I would assume these flags on the wall just refer to the different nationalities of people who have plunged the depths of the hole over the years, which is a typical thing to do in these sorts of places. But what about this weird flag here? Iago is right in that it clearly has something to do with South Africa, in that it seems to be a miniature South African flag on a blue field with a yellow line and some sort of crest thing in the corner. So let's see if we can solve this. All right, so South Africa is a former British colony that uses the English flag system. And in the English flag system, whenever you have a small version of the flag in the top corner, they call it an ensign. So I figured I'd just Google South African ensign crest until something close enough popped up. Aha, here is something close enough. It's the same flag, but with the old apartheid flag in the corner. And then from checking out the host site, which has a big archive of South African flags, we can see that our mystery flag is in fact the flag of the South African Police Service. And why would the police service flag be in Bushman's Hole, you ask? Well, as you might imagine, the South African police were quite interested when that guy drowned in the hole. And according to media reports, police divers spent a fair bit of time looking for him. So I guess they figured it was only fair to have their flag up on the wall too. Flag mystery solved. Okay, my friend Evan from Ohio sends me a picture of this flag, which he says he saw for sale at a garage sale in Cleveland, but could not recognize. He thought it was maybe the flag of some sort of international socialist group or something. So this is one of these little mass-produced polyester flags that they often sell at toy stores or souvenir shops. They always have the same little gold pointy thing at the top. You can see that many of my own little flags are done up in the same style. And over the years, in amassing my own flag collection, I must say that I have occasionally seen this flag for sale in some of the stores. As far as I know, it is not a flag for anything real. It is just a made-up flag for planet Earth. I mean, these little flags are primarily sold to children, and you can imagine that children would like the idea of there being a flag for planet Earth. So I assume that's why this was created. But these days, it is getting harder to find this style of Earth flag, in part because a lot of people have come up with some better ones, such as this very on-the-nose one, which is sometimes called the Earth Day flag, and is credited to the founder of Earth Day, John McConnell. Or this somewhat more interesting one, which was invented by a Swedish design student in 2015, and has since really taken off among the Earthling community. All right, next one comes from my friend Vincent in California, who simply says, large mass-produced flag seen in a suburban neighborhood. The neighborhood is known to be quite conservative. Now, if you live in Vancouver, as I do, you can be excused for thinking that this was maybe a Vancouver Canucks NHL flag. I mean, it has the team colors and the trademark giant V that used to be on the jerseys. But no, I'm up to date enough on my flag news to know that this is actually the recently designed flag of the vegan movement. Sorry, I know I say that word weird. The vegan movement. I guess it is maybe a little bit surprising for a vegan flag to be appearing in Vincent's Republican neighborhood. But then again, maybe not. I mean, vegan activists are nothing if not provocative. This picture is actually kind of a living monument to that old joke about vegans. How do you know if someone's a vegan? Oh, they'll let you know. My friend Solomon from the UK has also been snooping on his neighbors. There's a chap who lives near to me in Manchester who has a flagpole. Normally, he just puts veteran / NHS flags up, but recently, he started flying a flag I've never seen before. I've done some digging, but couldn't find anything on it. So the big clue here was that Solomon's neighbor was previously advocating for veterans and the NHS, which is, of course, the British public health system. To me, this suggests that the guy is some sort of virtue signaling goody-goody, which made me think, what other issue would such a person want strangers to know he is on the right side of? It can't be world peace, because we all know what the world peace flag looks like. And even though there are like 10,000 LGBT flags these days, this ain't one of them. But what about climate change? Is there a climate change flag? Indeed there is. It's another one of these newfangled activist flags made by some guy with a webpage who dreams of being the next guy who made the rainbow flag. But unlike the rainbow flag, apparently the colors on the climate change flag don't actually mean anything. Just use your imagination, the site tells us. Now, much like our troubled planet, the climate change flag is really catching fire. At present, there are over 100 currently in circulation. So let no one ever tell you that Manchester is not ahead of the curve, Solomon. Flag mystery solved. All right, and now let us close with a fun new segment that I call JJ attempts to crowdsource an answer to a flag mystery that has been bugging him all week. So here is a photo submitted by my friend Andrew from New Jersey, who says, while on vacation to a crowded Jersey shore, I encountered my first mysterious flag. It has two gold bars down the middle and three gold bars slanted across the two middle ones on a blue background. That could be wrong because it was wrapped around its own pole and I was sort of far away from it. Additionally, the American flag was right next to it. I have no idea what it is / means. I thought it could possibly be a French Quebec flag, because a lot of French Canadians vacation at Jersey shores. Quebecers, they're everywhere, aren't they? Now, I tried my best to solve this flag mystery, but the crumpled nature of the photo makes it difficult. I am fairly sure it does not have something to do with French Canadians, however, as I feel I know most of their flags. My working theory is that it is either some sort of particular Jersey thing, or maybe the flag of some sort of ethnic group of Americans, given he was flying it beside the American flag. But if you recognize this obscured obscurity, please let me know in the comments below. And if you have a flag mystery that you would like to see me solve in a future video, please drop me an email. Please don't send it to me in Instagram though, because those are much harder to keep track of. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you all next week.